Good morning, students. Today again we are going to start with the chapter Atoms and Molecule, continuing with the topic Laws of Chemical Combination. We were doing Law of Conservation of Mass. Now further taking one more example, I am taking example of barium chloride and sodium sulfate. Now in this slide we are taking solution of barium chloride and sodium sulfate. Both are colorless solution, and in the test tube we are taking sodium sulfate and in flask we are taking barium chloride. In big flask, this big flask, we will cork the flask so that there is no loss of the mass. Now what we will do before mixing the two solutions, we will weigh the flask, and after mixing the solution, how we will mix? We will tilt the test tube in the flask and then we will allow the both the solution to mix. So what after we will see, after mixing there is formation of white PPT. What are the PPT? PPT are precipitates which are insoluble in the solution and remain suspended, and after some time they get settled in the solution. Okay, so white color precipitates are formed in the solution. How? Barium chloride when reacts with sodium sulfate, then he is saying there is formation of barium sulfate with sodium chloride. So there are white PPT of barium sulfate. After mixing, he is saying after mixing the solution again, the weight, it when we weigh the flask, the weight it remains the same. So before mixing and after mixing the solution, if the weight it remains the same, means the mass it remain the conserve before the reaction of the reactants and after mixing of the reactants, means the reaction follows the law of conservation of mass. So this is the example which I have taken from your NCERT book. Continuing further, we will take the next law of constant proportion. Now according to law of constant proportion, we know compounds are composed of two or more elements. The proportion in which elements are present in the compound remains the same, irrespective of its method of preparation. For example, pure water obtained from any source and from any country will always contain two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. So hydrogen and oxygen respectively combined together in the ratio of 1:8 by their mass number. So we can say, see, the formula of water is H2O. So hydrogen has two atoms and oxygen has one atom. And if I write H2O, then we can write the mass number of them, that is H2O. If I write the mass number, then I know H2O. Hydrogen mass number is 1. Hydrogen mass number is 1 and oxygen mass number is 16. But here hydrogen, the two atoms are present, so 1 multiplied by 2, total mass will be 2, and that of oxygen it will be 18. If we simplify it, dividing both by 2, it will be 1:8. 1:8 means the two atoms, they combine in a fixed ratio. Hydrogen and oxygen, they combine in a fixed ratio, that is 1:8. Either the water is of any source, irrespective of any source, they are in a fixed ratio, that is 1:8. Is that clear? So always compounds combine in a fixed ratio by their mass number. That is law of definite proportion. Similarly, we can take few more examples like carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, if we consider the mass number of carbon, carbon is having mass number, that is 12, and oxygen is having mass number 16. But in oxygen mass number is 16. 16 combines with 2, that is equal to 32. So when we simplify, that comes out to be 3:8. So means carbon and oxygen, they combine in a fixed ratio, the ratio will be, that is 3:8. That will be 3:8. So we can say the compounds, they combine in a fixed ratio, and that is law of definite proportion. Okay. So you can take any example, and now you must have learned the mass number. By taking their mass number, you simplify their mass number and you come to a whole number ratio. That whole number ratio is the fixed ratio for their mass number of that particular compound. Okay. जैसे मैंने अभी आपको वाटर का बताया, दैट इज 1:8, एंड फॉर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन दे कंबाइन इन अ फिक्स रेशियो, दैट इज 3:8. ओके, नाउ कमिंग अप फर्दर टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, ही इज सेइंग दैट सिमिलरली ही इज शोइंग हाउ वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड. जैसे मैंने आपको कैलकुलेट करके दिखाया है दैट हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन दैट इज 2:18, ठीक है ना, सो दैट इज 1:8. ओके, एंड और एग्जांपल्स, डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स कैन बी टेकन लाइक अमोनिया. अमोनिया इज NH3. व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ अमोनिया? एन इन NH3 nitrogen and hydrogen, they are present. We know nitrogen, that is the mass number 14, and hydrogen has NH3. Teen hai na atom hydrogen ke, to 14:3 will be the whole number ratio that combine in the ammonia compound. Okay, so there are different compounds in which